Hey guys, welcome to Couple. Please like and subscribe if you like this video. It would be hard to imagine the hashtag MeToo movement were Donald Trump not the US president. It would be harder still to account for the surge in women running in this year's midterm elections had he not won the White House in 2016. If there is still a glass ceiling in the Democratic Party, it belongs in a museum by now. Some call the female groundswell the pink wave or Hillary Clinton's revenge. We should therefore brace ourselves for an orange backlash. Mr. Trump knows his fate hinges on how well women do in November. Democrats should be wary of playing into his hands. Women's rise in American politics has been astonishingly slow. A century after American women won the national vote, less than a fifth of Congress is female. Just 27 of the chief executives of the Fortune 500 companies are women. Apart from Nikki Haley, U.S. Ambassador to the UN, and a couple of strategists, the only prominent woman on Mr. Trump's team is his daughter Ivanka. It is not clear if Melania Trump, the other significant woman in the White House, is on her husband's side. When asked last year where she would like to spend Christmas, the First Lady said a deserted island. If women simply voted for other women, Mr. Trump's goose would be cooked. But politics does not often work like that. More than half of the white women who voted in 2016 chose Mr. Trump over Mrs. Clinton. That rose to more than 6 in 10 of women without a college degree. On some Trumpian issues, such as fear of terrorism, the median female voter is to the right of the male. On others, such as guns in schools, she is to the left. Where do women stand on Mr. Trump's attitude towards women? Somewhere between disgusted to forgiving is the answer. It is not clear which way hashtag MeToo can sway an election. This is where Democrats should tread carefully. Al Franken, one of the left's 2020 hopefuls, resigned his Senate seat in January after 8 women said he had groped them. Though the allegations paled in comparison to those about Mr. Trump, he was ejected without a hearing. His hopes vanished after Kirsten Gillibrand, the New York senator and presidential hopeful, called on him to resign. Many of her colleagues followed suit. So far, so good. But here is the rub. More than half of voters in Mr. Franken's home state of Minnesota approved of the job he was doing. An even higher share of female voters, 57%, agreed. Few Democratic voters, and even fewer women, thought he should have resigned. Which brings me to the orange backlash. The hashtag MeToo movement has two excesses Mr. Trump will be sure to exploit. The first is the rush to pronounce guilt without a hearing. Mr. Franken requested an inquiry, but politics lacks patience. Ms. Gillibrand is now facing a backlash of her own from Democratic donors. What may help her with primary voters could boomerang in a general election. Second, the viral campaigns against men have sometimes conflated misbehavior with criminal offenses. That is the nature of Twitter. Many careers have been ended. Some of the men deserve lengthy jail sentences. Others should improve their manners. The latter may be collateral damage in a just war, but there are Americans of all genders who question the fairness of viral justice. Against this, there is the Republican Party. It should be little surprise so few women are applying to be candidates for a party led by Mr. Trump. In December, Alabama's voters broke the habit of a generation by electing a Democratic senator. Republicans had put up a man, Roy Moore, who was accused of serially dating teenaged girls. Mr. Moore is now backing a Senate candidate in Missouri who calls feminists she-devils. If Republicans keep tolerating men like this, they will write themselves into oblivion. But such candidates tend to be outliers. Here is the more likely trend. Conservatives, for the most part, will stick with men such as Mike Pence, the vice president. Mr. Pence is an evangelical who has vowed never to dine alone with a woman except his own wife. He has been pilloried for his prudishness. How can anyone work in today's world without being alone with a female colleague? It is altogether Saudi Arabian. But liberals are heading in a similar direction. Nearly a quarter of millennial males in the USA inviting a female peer for a drink is a form of harassment. Both parties are being tugged towards prudish extremes. One magnifies male anger, the other female. Neither captures the complexity of the average voter. If politics descends into a gender war, Mr. Trump could be the winner.